The husband of a bride who died on her honeymoon on Hamilton Island has now been charged over her death. Sydney couple Robbie and Marina Morgan were in a golf buggy when it overturned in June. The 29-year-old died at the scene. Queensland police have now charged Mr. Morgan with driving without due care and attention, causing death, as well as seatbelt offences and using a mobile phone. Police claim they've smashed a dangerous criminal group allegedly responsible for a violent home invasion and kidnapping earlier this year. Almost a dozen simultaneous raids unfolded across the city early this morning. Four men are now behind bars, with more arrests expected.
Swarming the suburbs early, tactical officers move in before 6 a.m.
Chopper sound was so loud, and they just kept going round and round and round and round.
In Revesby, 29-year-old Anthony Taufahema arrested alongside a 17-year-old. His family has a history of violent crime, including involvement in the 2002 murder of senior constable Glenn McEnally.
They are extremely dangerous. They're severely beaten and assaulted their victims.
Sone Satauti and Toa Falantuli were also taken into custody.
The people they were targeting were drug suppliers who were in possession of large quantities of drugs and cash.
11 raids in Revesby, Lidcombe, Strathfield, Girraween, Villawood, Botany, North Ryde and Homebush. Police finding two semi-automatic handguns and a revolver.
There's a lot of nice cars which I wonder where they come from.
I'd be very interested to find out what was going on down the bottom of the hill.
The group is believed to be linked to a violent home invasion in Caddens in September and a kidnapping in October. A man threatened and assaulted at gunpoint in a Ryde car park. Police allege these men were about to take their criminal behaviour to another level, claiming more arrests will be made.
Today's arrest has made a significant impact against this particular group and dismantled their ability to continue their criminal activities.
Isabel Mullen, 7 News.
In April this year, the Robbery and Serious Crime Squad commenced Strike Force Guinea to investigate or proactively investigate a criminal group that were heavily involved in a number of home invasion kidnapping style offences. That culminated today with the execution of 11 search warrants across Sydney, with the utilisation of the Tactical Operations Unit, PAWS, Raptor and other sections from the police. Those search warrants were executed in the suburbs of Revesby, Villawood, Lidcombe, Strathfield, Homebush West, Botany, North Ryde and Girraween. As a result of today's search warrants and Strike Force Girraween's investigations, 4 males have been arrested today. A 29-year-old male and a 17-year-old male were arrested at Revesby by members of the Tactical Operations Unit. A 31-year-old male was arrested at Lidcombe and a 32-year-old male was arrested at Strathfield. Also today, 3 handguns were located during the execution of these search warrants, 2 semi-automatic handguns and 1 revolver. Strike Force Guinea identified during the course of the investigation 2 particular offences that these offenders will be arrested and charged for today. The first offence occurred on the 26th of September this year at Caddens. That was a home invasion style offence, an aggravated break, enter and steal offence, where 2 offenders were armed with a pistol and forced their way into the premises. The victim at that location, a male victim, escaped through jumping through a broken glass window. The offenders then stole unknown items from that location and left the scene with another 2 males in a grey V-dub hatchback. The second offence occurred on the 12th of October this year. That occurred at Ryde, at an address in Ryde. That involved 4 males armed with a pistol and a baton, where a male victim was abducted, severely beaten and then released. That male was taken to an unknown location where he was threatened and assaulted, and a substantial amount of cash and drugs were stolen from that male. I'd like to say that this particular group of offenders or males are extremely violent in their actions and dangerous and reckless, hence the use of the Tactical Operations Unit this morning to effect their arrest and the other units. Today's arrest has made a significant impact against this particular group. It's certainly removed certain members from that group and dismantled their ability to continue their criminal activities. The men are known to police at this stage, and I'm not at any liberty to disclose their names at this stage.
Does the group have a name?
Look, they do have a name, but I can't say what their names are. They will be appearing in court this afternoon.
So to be clear, is this a gang or just a group of people? Is this a particular gang that you think was forming recently that you had to break up before it became more entrenched, or what's the significance?
No, I wouldn't refer to them as a gang. They're just a group of associates, family and friends that are involved in these home invasion style offences.
So these men that you've arrested, they're related to each other?
Yes.
Are the victims different victims or the same man assaulted?
No, different victims on both occasions. And I can indicate that the victims, or they were targeted offences, not random.
Are there other people that police are still looking for in this group, or is the group four people?
The investigations are ongoing, and there are other people that we are looking at.
So more people in the group?
Yes.
So why did they specifically target these victims? How did these victims catch their eye?
These offences are drug-related. And our investigations in that side of us, or that aspect of the investigations, are ongoing.
Is it linked to importation, exportation of drugs?
Not necessarily linked to the importation of drugs, no. Linked to more domestic supply of drugs.
Distribution in the Sydney area?
Yes.
The weapons, will you be looking to see if they're linked to any other crimes recently?
We will forensically examine those weapons and see if they are matched to any other unsolved crimes.
Are the victims being cooperative with you, or are they...
Look, with these type of investigations, we do experience some difficulty with victims in these type of offences, and they are cooperating to a certain level.
Do you have any idea how many drugs they were distributing, or the street value of drugs they're putting out?
No, sorry, I don't.
11 search warrants, is that considered a large number, and were you expecting to make more arrests today?
No, look, the execution of 11 search warrants is significant, and we have achieved our goals today by arresting those four offenders and recovering three handguns.
What happened in relation to the kidnapping earlier this year? Who was that person? Was he linked to the group?
No, that's not linked to this matter.
It's not linked to this matter at all?
No.
It's on their media release. What's the significance of that?
That's the male from the Caddens address. He was the male that was kidnapped, but that's not linked to the matter you're referring to.
Oh, the media release refers to Ryde car park as a kidnapping, when the person got put in the car and assaulted at a different address. So that is
the Ryde address, sorry, yes.
How much cash was stolen at that time?
It's unknown, but we do believe it is a significant amount of cash.
And was that an organised meet-up at that location with that person, or they set upon that?
No, it looks like it was an ambush.
Sorry, just to be clear, the kidnapping in Caddens is not linked to this group of men?
Sorry, yes. So the kidnapping in Caddens and the aggravated breaking into home invasion in Caddon and the home invasion kidnapping at Ryde are linked to this group of men.
And you pinpointed those two incidents, but at the beginning you said this group is believed to perhaps be involved in a number of others. Are you expecting, once you've laid charges for these incidents today, that there will be wider...
Yeah. Look, our investigations are ongoing, and I do expect that there'll be further offenders arrested and further crimes identified.
How dangerous is this group?
Look, they are extremely dangerous. They're using firearms and weapons in the execution of their offences, and they've severely beaten and assaulted their victims.
Is it a group that have been around for a long time?
Oh, look, I can't really comment on that, no.
Any
bikey links? Bikey links? Not that I'm aware of.
In terms of releasing the information to the public, police were preparing to do that before the media stumbled across it this morning. Why is it in the public interest to let the public know about this group? It seems a bit obscure and we don't know much about them at all. What's the point? Why tell people about these people at all?
Well, we don't generally give a heads up in relation to what we propose to do when we're going to arrest these type of offenders. It's a safety issue for both the police and to ensure that the offenders are arrested safely. Our concern was that these offenders were escalating in their particular crimes, and there was potential that they were going to re-offend in the near future, and we needed to put a stop to that, and that's why we moved in today in order to sort of dismantle this organisation.
Are they linked to the Hansio Alamedine family?
Certainly not. No, this appears to be a completely separate group.
Do you believe that they were trying to establish themselves as some kind of players in the drug circles and try and become a more established gang? Is that the point of dismantling them now? And are you concerned that there are people out there that you're trying to send a message to today not to do a similar thing? Is that...
Look, it certainly sent a message out that if you're going to be involved in these types of crimes, you're going to end up behind in jail with handcuffs, unlike those particular offenders. They certainly weren't getting to the stage where they were... They're not drug dealers in the sense that they're drug suppliers. They're more targeting drug dealers and stealing the proceeds of the drug dealers' crimes and their drugs from them.
There were two women that were killed in Revesby earlier this year, and allegations of drug-related, I guess, offences there. Is there any sort of link to those two women in that investigation?
No, there is no links with this group to that particular investigation.
What sort of drugs?
I don't know. I think it may just be cocaine or methamphetamine.
I guess we're just trying to establish the importance of where they lie and what's led it to become... I mean, I know we talked about media coming across it, but the footage was going to be released to media of sort of breaking up this ring. So I guess we're just trying to see where it fits and what the importance of... the significance of this arrest.
Look, all I could say is that there's a group of friends who were involved in kidnapping, aggravated break and enter type offences, and the people they were targeting were drug suppliers who were in possession of large quantities of drugs and cash.
We understand they're a family from the Pacific Islands. Did they have links to the Pacific Islands? Were they coordinating any sort of international element to the operation?
Look, there's no evidence or information at this stage to suggest their operation was international.
All right. You good? Good. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you.